curiosity, insight, spirit, opportunity. If you think about it, all of these names of past Mars rovers are qualities we possess as humans. We're always curious and seek opportunity.
Hello, my name is Alexander Mather. I was a seventh grader at Lake Braddock Secondary School when I named the Mars Perseverance Rover. As a space nerd, when I get this opportunity to help NASA, I immediately knew refusal of this challenge was not an option.
We have the spirit and insight to explore the moon, Mars, and beyond. But if rovers are to be the qualities of us as a race, we missed the most important thing, perseverance.
I do remember that one of the biggest contenders early on was teamwork, because I knew I wanted a very human quality. Teamwork at the time, it was there, and I thought I was going to go with it for a while. But then I thought of perseverance, and it's definitely important in what makes a human human. And perseverance kind of just came to me.
And speaking of exciting, this is the big day where we find out the name of NASA's next Mars rover. This journey started back in August. We had 28,000 entries, 4,700 judges, and it's all brought us right here to learn that winning name. I am in Burke, Virginia at Lake Braddock Secondary School. Lake Braddock, can you make some noise?
I didn't think I would get the opportunity to help NASA for a very long time. And the fact that I got to them, it felt amazing.
And the name of this mission is... Perseverance!
Alex Mather, come to the stage.
Mars launches have a window that occurs, I think, every 26 months. And in this window, you can launch a spacecraft on an elliptical orbit such that it will intercept with Mars. Any other time, if you try to launch to Mars, it's going to cost a lot of fuel and a lot of energy, and it's just not worth it outside of that launch window. And NASA did not want to do that. So it was their top priority for a while to make sure that this thing gets into space when it did. Point is, they were going to have a group of people who were going to go, and the question was whether or not we would go. Are we mission essential enough to see the launch? There was a lot of planning that went into it, especially when we got there. It was very clear that NASA spent a lot of time and effort making sure that this would be as safe as possible. It's really thanks to those amazing people that we got to go, and My heart goes out to them.
Hello, my name is Alexander Mather, and directly behind me is the Perseverance Mars rover, which starts its journey to Mars tomorrow. It's riding on an Atlas V outfitted with four extra SRBs, and tomorrow at booster ignition, I think around 9 a.m., it's going to leave the Earth's atmosphere and begin its year and a half long journey to Mars. And I'm really excited to be here, right here. This is the closest they will allow you to get to the actual rover. And I'm very glad that I was given this wonderful opportunity. And I'm definitely very excited to not only see the science that's coming back, but definitely to see the amazing launch tomorrow.
So it was me, my mom, my dad, and my younger sister, Kira. They also had another family, the Rupanis. Their daughter, Vanessa Rupani, actually named the Ingenuity Mars helicopter.
And it's ironic, you know, Moo, because the name Perseverance was chosen by a seventh grader who, at the time he submitted that name, he didn't know that we would be faced with a global pandemic. So we are glad to have him and his family here, along with the student who named the helicopter, to watch the launch in person.
Their names are Alexander Mather and Vanessa Rupani, and they are watching from the fifth floor balcony of our engineering building, just a stone's throw away from the countdown clock.
It was also really cool because I knew that the place where I was standing was the same place where family of astronauts would traditionally see the astronauts launch in the shuttle era. We're standing up there, we're watching, there are a bunch of really cool NASA people. I'm so glad I got to meet, by the way. They're all absolutely, they're heroes. And this thing, it launches.
Eight, 7, 6, 5, 4. Engine ignition, 2, 1, 0.
Zero.
Release.
And liftoff. As the countdown to Mars continues, the perseverance of humanity launching the next generation of robotic explorers to the Red Planet.
And it's going into the air, and it's speeding up, wow. And then the shockwave hits, about half a second later. Just this powerful force, and you can feel it in your chest, this rumble. And all the birds and bugs for miles around are going crazy. All the car alarms basically exploded, and just as abruptly as it started, it stopped. It's gone, not 9 seconds after leaving the pad. It's already out of sight, leaving behind this large trail of smoke, and it's gone. It's a space mission now. The emotion I felt, it was, I think, mainly gratitude. Like, I'm happy that it was chosen, but really, I just feel like a part of the great team that made this happen. A part of the amazing team that will definitely go down in history, because, especially with the people I met there, they were scientists, they were engineers. These people were awesome, and I want to be just like them. And coming out the other end of it, I definitely feel like, I feel like I got to be a part of that team. And I'm so grateful that I got to be.
We as humans evolved as creatures who could learn to adapt to any situation, no matter how harsh. We are a species of explorers, and we will meet many setbacks on the way to Mars. However, we can persevere. We, not as a nation, but as humans, will not give up. The human race will always persevere into the future.